Yes, we've got, just checking what remains for the day, the plate final, 3:35 coming up shortly between counties Manukau and Auckland. And then the cup final, can Harbour make it three in a row? Can they take their sixth title and equal the best record for a province with Auckland? Or can it be Bay of Plenty? Counties Manukau also close to making the top playoffs, just missed out on a count back to Wellington. They've got some star players there, Danny Lee and Tuakarina brothers Massey and Patrick. Auckland, they looked strong. They're a very young team, but they've got some experience in Craig de Goldie and Namasia Valance, Mana Ashford, of course, three key players, but youth throughout. And a little bit unlucky yesterday that they didn't make the major playoffs, although Hawke's Bay just caught them napping in the last game of round robin play and dispatched them into the plate section. So it's very tight. Fran Avodica's called one from one. We'll get a prediction from Melody on how she thinks this game will go.
Very difficult to call, actually, because both sides are excellent sevens sides. They spread the ball wide. You can see the county's wingers stay right out to the sideline, which means their inside players have got plenty of room to move.
Yeah, both teams have won this competition. Auckland, as I said, six times. They're the record holder. Counties have won three times. So it's probably a little bit uncomfortable for them that they're playing for the plate. Nevertheless, this is what they've been left with. It'll be an all-out effort. Yes, the advantage goes the way of Auckland, and Kipu passes it on to Mana Ashford for the chip and chase.
Hands up.
Managed to regather. Well did Ashford. The wind has really picked up quite a bit here, with Auckland inside to Rokathoko. And he's standing on his feet. He manages to offload, but they can't hang on.
Four fellas, no advantage.
Seggy just putting it on the ground. And this is the transfer, the final transfer. Managed to shake off a couple Rokathoko, but enough defence there to disrupt the distribution.
This Auckland side seems to have more power players than the counties team. You can see the size of Sione Kipu, for instance. He's huge, and he actually plays wing for 15s this year.
So, counties spreading it very wide, very quickly. And here's a player to watch out for, Koiatu Koiatu. Is been most effective in this tournament. He was quickly wrapped up. Auckland have also been watching the pool play. They know the dangers, and they've turned it over. Taking their time. Ashford out line to Kipu, and he may have got there. He has, so he scored early as Sione Kipu.
He sort of brushed him off like a fly, really.
Auckland try scorer Sione Kipu.
Basically, that's just simple sevens there, keeping the width, as I mentioned before, that both teams like to do, and it just gives more room on the outside for Kipu to score. Great handling by the insides there. Mana Ashford, lovely step just to hold the defence slightly.
There's those inevitable comparisons between Kipu and no doubt Jonah Lomu, with the size and the strength out wide. Always a little bit unfair for that young player coming through, but he's certainly made his mark early in this final of the plate. The conversion unsuccessful, so Auckland just the 5-point lead. They'll be happy with that.
They will be happy. It's important to get the first points on the board. It's just a psychological edge for the start.
Tuakarina manages to get a hand to it, and to Massey Tuakarina, who clears downfield, scampering back for it, Mana Ashford, but he knows it's going to go out. Also knows that his team will have the put in, and that'll satisfy him. Almost a quiet start here. Auckland looking very composed and relaxed for a final.
They certainly are, which is a good thing because they've got a lot of young players in that Auckland side this time round. Your key players, Craig de Goldie and obviously Mana Ashford, to hold in those young, experienced but very talented players.
So Auckland have it again, running onto it with confidence. Rokathoko right on the halfway and dumped. Again, the recycle change direction. Look at a good back line. Their backs get into position very quickly indeed. And Kipu Keeps it in play. It's held on to by the jersey. The Goldie couldn't hold it, so Counties, Manukau will have their first taste of assertive attack. And they make pretty good use of it. Spread it wide, and here's a chance for Koiatu. Steps again, beats a couple, accelerates. Caught in the third tackle from De Goldie. He wasn't fooled. Good bit of cover defence by De Goldie. So Nawini stepped inside, and this will be their try. Billy Nawini. Nice stepping from several members of the Counties team to bring up their first try of the final.
For Counties Manukau, the try scorer, Billy Nawini.
A bit of individual brilliance at the end of that move there. Although it was started by a very wide pass from one of the Counties players from that last ruck. Right there, number five, Massey Tuhakairaina. Very nice pass. That's one of the basics of sevens, to have a wide pass. Usually the drills Gordon Titchens uses is five players across the width of the field, and they have to pass it to each other, which is quite a hard task. Usually it takes about 10 players.
And into the wind, it's supposed to be a little bit easier. But of course, what was easy was the conversion for Counties Manukau right under the posts. They led 7-5. They've gone for the short drop kicks, and they're studying his form. I assume it's the sevens form, not the not racing form. On me.
Looks like he's checking out the names of certain players he's never seen before.
Yes, there's plenty of new faces here, and they don't always match the program, as though the program and compilers did their best possible. But teams did turn up with a couple of players that were different than forecast.
It's just the names I can't pronounce that I'm worried about.
Sure they won't mind. Auckland. Well, it was a nice little roll there, because that set the ball nicely for the players following on. Kepu.
Hands off now, hands off, Red.
Auckland just playing, it's almost half pace, just waiting for Counties to come forward and create the gap, and that's what's happened. With Segi able to just run there towards the touchline, there was no one with him, so they're just throwing about, to almost dictating the terms.
But, and waiting for something like that to happen.
Exactly, and they've got a penalty, and of course you can have a shot at goal, you very rarely see it. It's got to be a drop kick though. And perhaps in a very tight situation late in the game, they may try that. But, not on this occasion, the tap. There's probably numerous moves on. Edwards, the first off runner. And into Goldie. Kepu from 5 metres out. County's defence did a good job on the big man. But De Goldie, oh, did he get it down? The referee says he lost it forward. And he went for the lunge. He has a chance to place the ball. Just lost control, and he's not arguing the point.
He will be rather brassed off with himself, I'd say.
Very nicely put.
On me. Engage. Give it straight.
That's close. What do you reckon?
No, wait for me. You wheeled it, we'll take the free kick. Where you going?
So Counties, not complaining, Lee takes off with it. And the offload is nice for Massey Tuakarina. We'll see what sort of pace he's got, because chasing him is Ashford. And just eludes him, plenty of support. But the pass to Danny Lee was forward.
Well, it was basically a battle of pace on pace with Massey and Mana Ashford against each other. They're probably around about the same speed.
Ashford in the sweeping role, I think, did well here. Just forced him to, yes, make a decision, delay and make a decision, and therefore the rest of the defenders got back on time.
Perhaps he could have backed himself slightly more then and really put the ball underneath his shoulder hand and gone for it.
You see, that sweeping role, it's important at someone with speed and experience, isn't it? Because that's a very, very tough role.
It is. You have to be fit as well, so you've got to run around a lot.
Yes. And here is Sirokotoko. Back inside and lost forward. Big chance for Counties here. because Auckland a little bit disorganised, but it'll be a test of their ability to get back in. And Kipu's doing a lot of work both in attack and defence. He's got right across.
Take the first penalty. He came from the wrong side, but you held on.
So the holding on penalty goes the way of Auckland. So County's quickly shut down. They got the ball on the 22. They never got over it.
Yes, they took the wrong option there. They actually ran into the Auckland defence. There was maybe one or two Counties players against three Auckland.
Oh, there's Ashford again. Able to get up because he wasn't held. But on this occasion, players going straight off their feet were penalised. And Counties Manukau through Massey to Akaraina. One of the players has really showed some penetrative skills. Has broken the line, gone all the way, and touched down behind the right hand upright.
Gee, that was simple stuff, really. It was a try created from nothing, just basic missed tackle by Craig De Goldie, in fact.
So that's the halftime score with a successful conversion. Counties Manukau by 14-5. Auckland look, well, I said in control and composed. Perhaps they need the energy, to have a bit more energy.
They do, actually. They've had most of the ball. Perhaps they could use a couple of their power players, like Sione Kipu, as I mentioned him before, just to hit some short, quick balls, rather than just using the wide game that they are at the moment. So using more confrontation would probably be a good way to go in the second half.
Just about to take the bowl presentation, and we've seen a lot of happy teams, and none more so than this with Manawa 2 collecting and raising the trophy from Tony Norton, and well, I'm sure we'll be drinking out of it later. Lots of smiling faces. Which two of these sides will be celebrating shortly and holding up their plate? We'll find out. Auckland perhaps slight favourites going into the match. They've got some work to be done.
They certainly do. In a sevens game, two tries or one try down is a reasonable amount of work, but who knows what can happen in the second half.
1 minute. Just see Auckland's first effort. This is in the first moment or two, and this is where we thought Auckland were coasting, if anything. It was relatively simple. Gave it to the big man Kipu, and he just reached out the huge hand and placed it. Counties come up with a couple of tries of their own, and I think one pattern with these tries is there's been a couple of line breaches, a couple of missed tackles, and Auckland have got to look at that part.
They do, actually. And another area Auckland has to improve in to take this game out is actually some of the stretch that workload out. At the moment, you're seeing Mana Ashford doing a lot of the work, and also Craig De Goldie. So some of those other players need to put their hand up and help them out, basically.
So Counties Manukau will have the restart. They've got a handy 9-point margin over Auckland. And they too would look forward to some success this year after relegation from NPC. It would be a minor consolation, perhaps, to take home the plate. But 7's Rugby is where they've created a good reputation over the years. Auckland just disrupted there by an illegal hand. So Auckland first to score in the first half. Will they open the scoring this time?
Looks like they're starting to set up rucks on purpose there so that they can organise their back line and put a few moves on.
Just a slight handling error slowed down the transfer, but Rokotoko has got no room to go on the outside, just dumped by Koiatu, whose defence has been pretty good. He was on his feet, the referee says play on. Got no problem with that, but he lost it forward in the transfer. So Auckland now, rather fortuitous regathering of possession. No Counties players there committed, so there's still some work to do to find some space. They've done it. Siggy goes out, goes in, is confronted by Tuakaraina, who is determined to drag him down. And you have to say that Massey Tuakaraina has done his fair share of work for Counties Manukau, both forward and back.
Leave it, leave it.
Oh, and that Auckland player.
really, when you get a break like that in sevens, you have to score. And there was no support play for that Auckland player there. Like I said, work rate has to go up.
County's able to keep it in play, but at the expense of turning over the possession. It's really untidy stuff from both teams. Auckland through Ashford, yet again, showing some composure and getting them back on the scoring sheet. Nice try, Mona Ashford, and the team should say thanks very much.
Wow, he's got some nice footwork there, that's for sure.
Auckland tries
just out and out individual try that one. There's nothing really more to say about that. Mistake from Counties. Step off his right foot and another. Bad defence from Counties.
You can see Ashford said turning around. He's always looking at what his options are. Mm. And that's the value of that experience we've talked about. He looked sideways. He's still looking, even though there was no one between him and the goalpost, not wanting to give up this opportunity to score.
And he keeps, the most important thing there, he actually keeps the ball in two hands, which keeps the defence in two minds. They don't know if you're going to go for it or pass it. And obviously the winger took the person outside, Mana Ashford.
So 14-10, not able to convert, and that's the difference, the two conversions for Counties. They've scored under the bar, Auckland, and scored out wide. It's worth now almost a try to Counties to have those successful conversions. There's 6 minutes, just under 7 minutes, in fact, of this plate final. Counties, Manukau have the edge. Auckland have had most of the possession in the second half.
Both of the teams look very tired at the moment.
Yes, Counties, Patrick Tuakarona is propping the scrum. He's got a bit of a limp on.
On me.
In fact, he's hooking, I think.
Now. Ball's not out.
Ball goes out Auckland's way. And Ashford, they're just looking at him make a decision for us, and he does almost turn it inside to Rokathoko. But the ball got deflected down. Now Counties have a chance because Auckland not quite ready. And a kick and chase. Guess who? Massey Tuakarana. If anyone deserves to put Counties ahead, why did he pass? That's a bit of a question.
Leave it now.
I'll stop lauding his option selecting. As soon as he did that, it was a great start to the move.
Well, the option probably when he kicked it was not the greatest one to do, so...
Everything is pretty casual here from Counties. They could get across anyway, and they do. So not the most impressive sevens execution of sevens rugby, but Counties are going to say, we'll take the 5 points.
It's quite disappointing, really, the second half fatigue has set in. And I guess what some of the viewers don't get to see is some of the brilliant semi-finals and match play that we see earlier on when some of these players are fresher. Some really exciting games.
Is it a case of some of the senior players perhaps not taking enough control and not showing enough leadership?
I think the senior players on this Auckland side are doing that role very well. It's just some of the other players perhaps have to lift themselves as well. You can't win a game of sevens with just two players.
Indeed not. Counties managed to push it across the face of the post. Tuakarana unsuccessful. Get some credit for getting them down the field position. 19-10. Auckland need to score twice. They've got 4.5 minutes in which to do so.
I guess Counties have only really scored on Auckland's mistakes rather than creating their own tries as well.
Suggestion that maybe Auckland aren't able to sort of reorganise the defence quick enough.
Hands off now, hands off!
But, this time they've got ball from kickoff. They've turned it over because the maul collapsed.
It was a great take by Craig DeGoldie there, but great defence by Counties.
So Fano Boddicker described earlier with a short kick gives you a chance to contest and win it back from the kick-off, and that's exactly what Counties Manukau have done. Tuakarana able to flick on the pass, but Nauini, a try scorer earlier. Here's Denny Lee. Haven't seen a lot of him in finals action.
Hands up, Red!
This time it's Counties guilty of using their hands.
You're on their feet, let it go.
Players have a bit of a rest on the ground. But Auckland, they need to move quickly. 3.5 minutes, they need 2 tries. Rakatoko steps, no way through. 3 counties players organised. Ashford, what can he spark? And Siggy to back to Ashford. So much on that young man's shoulders. Buaza puts it underneath his legs. Goldie distributes, still looking for that half gap. They might have found it on the outside. They have. Willie Brahm, not enough pace or not enough room to beat the county's defence.
Not very tidy there. He had somebody inside him. Could have looked for the pass.
Quick throw in. Tuakaraina, for me, the player of this day, this match.
He has played well, that's for sure. He's the kingpin in that county side.
And perhaps not a player that Auckland would have been looking at, knowing that the likes of Lee, some more experienced players were in the side, that Tuakaraina has taken so much responsibility and done it well.
Well, just because you're a good 15s player doesn't necessarily mean you're a good 7s player. 7s players are certainly specialised these days. And you'd say that Massey would be certainly a specialist 7s player. Used to play on the wing for Bay of Plenty. Maybe he's moved counties for this season.
No, players move so often, it's impossible. He's also played some NPC for counties.
Right.
But, yeah, where he ends up, who knows. It's an end of November's gone, so all the transfer market should be complete. So we'll watch for his name next year. And that's the idea of this 7s tournament, is to tick a few names and see how they progress in later years. And you don't get a tick for dropping the ball in the tackle. Danny Lee on the response to Akaraina.
Beautiful.
Lovely
skills.
Pass, and this is the best maneuver of the match. Naibo, he will have too much pace and strength. Will he? No! No way did he get that ball down.
Held up.
And Lyndon Bray says, I agree, that's a 5-minute scrum, and that was the best move of the game. And about time we had some entertaining, high-quality ball skills.
Oh, that was lovely to watch. The back flips, 2 of them in a row. That's pretty unheard of, actually.
And I think that man on the ground's Mona Ashford, who came back and made that tackle. So if Auckland walk away with nothing from this tournament, it's not his fault, because he's worked so hard.
Certainly has.
Hitting the ball up and then to get back and make a tackle like that, that's astonishing. Good stuff. The gap's open up, and now when he scores the second, and after all that great defence, he could drive a bus through it, and he did.
Well, his feet, just on the balls of his feet. Beat the defence, here it is here. Just a step. And the Auckland defence took the dummy.
Ended up having to beat more counties players than Auckland. And this looks like another certainty. Late in the match, only seconds remaining, counties with that 16-point lead. And they've done it well. It's not the prettiest of finals, but counties will accept the trophy in good grace. Possibly the last transaction, as the time is up on the clock and Danny Lee kicks it into the car park, if there was one over there. Counties Manukau 26, Auckland 10, and perhaps just a minor upset.
That is a minor upset, but that's good for counties rugby, really, after the NPC dramas. But they certainly played better than Auckland in this final, and with some of those backflips and skills shown there at the end of the game, they deserve to win for sure.
From a Gordon Tetchin's point of view, he'll be looking at players who perhaps weren't as tired. They're still working hard at final time as those he wants to take on a longer tour.
That's right, although I do hear that the camps that he does hold are very, very hard. So anybody that's not fit at the end of that, gee, they are hard.
That's right. When you've got a World Series, there he is making his selections. He's not writing too many names down after that game, but... yeah, when you're taking players on a world trip, they've got the travel to focus, you've got a lot of things that can take it out of you, so fitness, so you come to this tournament fit, you'll get noticed.
That's right. The quality of sevens is really dictated by how fit you are in the end. You know, you can get players with explosive pace and speed, but if they don't have the aerobic base, then they just can't keep it up for the whole tournament. And the international sevens tournaments in Dubai, etc., they're all around about 3 or 4 games a day. So you've got to be in very good physical shape.
And he's not looking for players that necessarily, there's the big trophies, but it's not necessarily about just the quick guys who score the tries, is it? Because they want grafters, they want speedsters, and they want steppers. So he's looking for all those skills.
That's right. The Sevens team is usually divided up into the forwards, who are the players who take the ball up into confrontation. They're bigger, powerful. Then you've got the ball players. There's not very many of those around. You'd see that Massey is certainly like that.
Okay, let's go sideline. Danny Lee is with Stu Wilson.
Well, Danny, the local derby, Counties Manukau versus Auckland, it was a fairly dour affair, but good to get a win.
Very, very good to get a win. With the 15s, we've struggled over the last couple of years, and 7's, we had a good team, and I congratulate our boys who have come together really well and performed out there today. It's good.
Is the switch from 15 through the NPC and then into 7's, is it a major?
It's a completely different game, actually, but I enjoyed it and I look forward to playing 7's, but I can't say enough for my boys. They really perform well, and our goal was not to lose a game, and we went through on the first day and won two and drew one with Wellington, and they went back on a try count back, and we failed to go through the top section and end up in the second division section there. So our goal was not to lose a game, and as far as I look at it, we didn't lose a game over the whole 2 days.
It's nice to put your neighbours away too.
Yeah, that's right. It's always good to beat those guys, eh?
Enjoy the summer.
Thanks very much. Cheers.
Craig De Goldie, how are you, mate?
It's bad, how's it?
Well, maybe a little bit disappointing in this final.
Oh, yeah, we're a bit disappointed after last night. We needed a good Hawke's Bay side. And, just Counties got a good coach in Joe Taipirana, and he knows the game, and knew they're going to be tough. I'm not making excuses. We had a fairly young side. And it just proved in the day that they're better side.
Craig, just about Hawke's Bay, you know, the surprise little team. What happened there?
You tell me, bro. I don't know, they just...
They just jumped you at the wrong time?
No, they blew us through the middle. That's where we were weak on our D. We sorted it out this morning in our first game, and we went quite well there, but just couldn't bring it together in that last one. But Hawke's Bay, they're a good side. Young fella, tough Iosa, one name to watch. And he just took us through the middle, and it was all over.
Craig, you have a good summer too.
Yeah, we'll do. I think we're pretty full on from here on in, so
enjoy it.
Cheers, mate.
Okay, time now for ladies another presentation as we await the grand final.
Danny Lee, the captain of Counties Manukau.
Counties just about to come forward. And
with the plate. First of all, Telecom, Riwi, Tipani, and Tani Norton from New Zealand Rugby Football Union. Danny.
First of all, I'd like to thank all the organisers for putting up today's tournament. It's a great tournament to be involved with. Second, I'd like to thank my boys for putting in a great display over the last 2 days. We haven't lost a game in the last 2 days. Yesterday we drew one, we won two, and because of the try differential, we got put into the second into the plate section. So our goal was today to not lose a game, and so throughout the last 2 days we haven't lost a game. So to my guys, thanks very much. Great effort. We came together very well, and good stuff. Cheers.
Thanks very much to Counties Manukau.
So we've got the cup final not a few moments away. Fran Obotica back with us, and no doubt looking forward to North Harbour's performance.